their boat to land, they left all and followed it. I finally got the fish. The boat is filled. It's about to sink. And then it says again, and when they brought the boats to land, they left all of it and followed. How many are willing to leave all that you have and follow God? I know it sounds good, but it don't always feel good. How many are willing to leave that man to follow God? How many are willing to leave that woman and follow God? How many are willing to leave that church?
That's
I know
right.
Got quiet. And follow God. It's important that we realize that we have to follow God.
That's right.
They left all the stuff that they were blessed with in order to follow God. The God has given us a foretaste of what he had for these men. But he wanted them to be obedient. He wanted them to understand that I have greater stuff for you than this. This stuff, this is nothing. I got cattle on 1,000 hills. I'm not worried about some fish. Some fish, not. Amen. I'm going to move from there. Jesus had them to leave it all. As I said before, what are you unwilling to give up to follow Jesus in your life? What I have to say, and I won't be much longer, but I want you to know is that sometimes God has a blessing for us.
Yes.
But it doesn't take the shape that we want it to take.
Watch out.
We want to just somehow open the door of our car and there's $1 million sitting there. We don't want to go up. We don't even want to work for it.
That's
but
right.
Sometimes God has a funny way of blessing us.
That's right.
In a way. I think it's ironic that Jesus made them go in the boat. Made them go farther out in the boat. Got all the fish that they could eat. They could have fish fry. They probably have some porgies and some whitings. And they can do all types of stuff with that fish. And then they left it. You know what the key part of that scripture is? He didn't tell them to leave it. It says, and they left it at the shore. Sometimes when the Lord is speaking to you in your life, you have to know, I got to take some of this stuff off.
That's right.
Some of these fish, even though it was a blessing, is not part of my journey. Some of my friends may be away. They're not part of the journey. Some of the people who I hang around with are not part of the journey. They may have been a blessing in a certain season, but I now moved into a different season. In the season that I'm in now, I can't have you weighing me down. This job. I don't want to work this job no more. And then the time came where I got laid off. Was I upset?
I
said, Lord, why you take this good job from me? I'm making good money. I'm standing on my own. But he reminded me of the time where I'd be on the phone. I said, Lord, I just want to do ministry full time. I really don't want to work this job, but I'll do it until you get something better for me. But my goal is to do ministry full time. Full time. So when that time came for me to lose my job, I had a short memory. I forgot about the times that I prayed, I'm sick of this job. God, what else do do you have for me? It did not come the way that I expected it to come. I lost my job. I started getting weary. I had children I need to feed. I had a mortgage that I need to pay. And then the Lord said, I'll be with you.
Yeah.
Always to the end of
that's
the earth.
Right. That's
he
right.
said, if you abide in me and my word abides in you. He said, don't be weary in well-doing. You will reap what you sow.
That's right.
If you faint not. So what happened is, before unemployment came in, people who owed me money were calling me up saying, didn't I owe you some money? I want to come over and bless you with some food. I want to come over. God will find a way to bless you if you're faithful to him. If you're willing to step out. He kicked me out. But he's willing, if you're willing to step out into the deep and do what the Lord asked you to do.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I just want to close with this. The reason that I prayed for the Lord to give me a word on today, and I pray that it was a blessing, and it's a word for everyone, that no matter what goes on in your life, that you must follow Jesus.
That's right.